Well, joining me now for more on this is Professor of International Relations, Robert Patman. Hi, Robert. Thanks for joining us this evening.
Good evening, Janika.
OK, so this is President Zelensky's strongest language yet, saying the war is coming back to Russia. What's his strategy in saying that?
I think it's multifaceted. I think he wants to, first of all, unsettle the Russian army, which has been demoralised by the experience of fighting in Ukraine. And senior elements of the Russian army are sceptical about the campaign in Ukraine. I think it's also targeting the Putin regime, which is seen as weakened after its confrontation with Prigozhin, and therefore Putin may look vulnerable. And I think the third thing is, and perhaps most importantly, I think President Zelensky is trying to influence public opinion in Russia, showing that Russia, there are consequences for what Russia has done in neighbouring Ukraine, and that Russian people shouldn't assume they're immune from the consequences of what the Russian government's done in its name.
Yes. So is there any way it could backfire on Zelensky, do you think, this strategy?
I think some of the Western backers of Mr. Zelensky may get a little bit uneasy about their weaponry being used for such purposes, but I wouldn't want to overblow that. I mean, no strategy is waterproof or foolproof, but at the moment it seems that Zelensky's chosen his moment very carefully. He hasn't admitted full responsibility for these drone attacks, but he's everything but admitted it.
It seems pretty obvious, doesn't it? Well, are we witnessing a turning point in this war, do you think, Robert?
I think we're witnessing a landmark rather than a turning point in the steady escalation that Ukraine is the pressure of on the Russian defensive positions. And it's a clever strategy. You know, we also had drone attacks overnight in Crimea, as well as those ones in Moscow. And the counteroffensive is not going as quickly as many people expected it, but it's making steady progress. It's making progress in the Zaporizhia region and also Donetsk. So I think these attacks are intended to unsettle public opinion and indeed the Russian government, and at the same time keep up progress. We shouldn't lose sight of the fact that close Putin ally Dmitry Medvedev has said that if the counteroffensive succeeds, which he's tacitly conceding it might, then Russia might have to use nuclear weapons. But that's bluff, because China has already said that Russia can't use nuclear weapons under any circumstances after its invasion of Ukraine.
Robert Patman, thank you so much for explaining all that.
Thank you.